Hi, my name is Margaret. In this video, I'm going to introduce you to polymorphism. Polymorphism is one of the pillars of object-oriented programming, besides encapsulation and inheritance. The word polymorphism comes from the Greek. It means having multiple forms. Polymorphism is the characteristic of being able to assign a different meaning or usage to something in different contexts. Specifically, to allow an entity, such as a variable, a method, or an object, to have more than one form. Polymorphism enables you to write programs that process objects that share the same superclass as if they were all objects of that superclass. Let's look at an example. Let's say you have a class animal that has a method move and two subclasses, fish and bird, that override move. For our example, let's assume that the move method of animal prints moving, but the move method of the bird prints flying, and the move method of the fish prints swimming. Now you create an array of animals that includes birds and fish. So in this example, the animal array has three elements, one bird, one fish, and another bird. Notice that bird and fish are both reference types, so the array includes references to the actual objects on the heap. Let's assume we are taking a for each loop to access each of the animals in the array, and that we are going to invoke the method move on each of those array elements. If it happens to be a bird, it will print flying. If it happens to be a fish, it will print swimming. This is polymorphism. We invoke the method move on animals, but depending on the actual type of the animal, move does different things. It has different forms of behavior. Interfaces allow objects of unrelated classes to be processed in a polymorphic way. If a class implements an interface, all objects of that class provide the functionality described by the interface, and all objects of that class have an is-a relationship with the interface type. That is also true for all subclasses of the class. Now, the reason this also has to be true for subclasses is because interface methods are public. So the moment you have a subclass, it will inherit the public interface methods. Polymorphism enables you to deal in generalities and let the runtime environment handle the specifics. You can tell objects to behave in manners appropriate for those objects without even knowing the types, as long as the objects belong to the same inheritance hierarchy or they implement the same interface. Polymorphism facilitates the design and implementation of extensible systems. Software that invokes polymorphic behavior is independent of the object types to which messages are sent. Because of that, you can create new derived classes and add them with little or no modification to the general portions of the program. Only those parts that require direct knowledge of the new classes need to be modified. The Java virtual machine calls the appropriate method for the object that is referenced in each variable, not the method defined by the variable's type. The type of the reference object, not the type of the variable, determines which method is called. In other words, when we create a superclass variable and assign a subclass object, invoking an overridden method on that variable invokes the subclass behavior. Here is an example. Let's say we have an animal variable, it's called myAnimal, and I assign a bird instance, a new bird. If I say myAnimal move, it invokes the bird's way of moving, which is flying. Which specific move method is called depends on the instance that I'm referencing, not on the type of my variable. So in this case, I'm referencing a bird, and because of that, the bird's way of moving is going to be called. However, which methods can be called depend on the type of your variable. So if I have myAnimal, only animal methods can be called. I cannot call any bird specific methods. If I want to do that, I need to cast it to a bird first. So once again, which methods can be called depend on the type of my variable. What specific method is called depends on the type of the actual instance, in this case the bird. You can treat a subclass object as a superclass object, but not the other way around. I can assign a new instance of fish to my animal. I can treat a subclass object as a superclass object, a fish object as an animal object. Here is the implicit type conversion that Java is going to perform for us. That works because every fish is an animal, but it does not work the other way around. So if I would try to treat a superclass object like an animal as a fish and I try to assign it to a fish, this would not work. It would not work because not every animal is a fish. There is yet another reason why this wouldn't work. Animals do not have the fish-specific class members. Now I want to give a short demo of polymorphism. We are going to create the three classes animal, bird, and fish with the move method, where move prints moving for the animal, flying for the bird, and swimming for the fish. And both bird and fish derive from animal. So I'm starting here with my animal. It has only one method, it's public, void, it says move, and I'm just having a print statement here, system out print line moving. Now bird derives from animal, so I need the extends keyword animal. And here I'm going to say MO, control space, and that gives me a nice start. I'm going to exchange this for system out print line flying. And I'm going to fish. Fish also extends the animal, it also derives from animal, so I say extends animal. Once again, I start with the method name MO, control space, that gives me my method stub with the override annotation, and I'm exchanging the method body for a print statement, system out print line swimming. And once again, the caveat, typically we don't have any output in the classes. We want to separate functionality and display. I'm just doing it right now to demonstrate inheritance and polymorphism because it shows very clearly where the information comes from. So this is an exception for demo purposes only. Usually separate the functionality from your display. And now I'm going to my animal class, and in my animal class I'm going to create a variable of type animal. So here I say animal my is, let's say, a new bird. And I say my animal move. And I'm going to run that. And sure enough, it says flying. Now, if this would not have been a bird, if this would have been a fish, and I compile, it would say swimming. So this is polymorphism. I'm calling move on an animal variable, and depending on what my animal is actually referring, the method behavior changes. So right now, my move method performs the fish movement, even though it is called on an animal variable. Let's create a animal array. Let's say we have animal, which is called animals, and now we're going to initialize them with a new bird and a new fish and another new bird. And now I'm going to use a for each loop for each animal A in animals, and I am going to invoke the move method. So here I say a.move, and you will see that we have flying, swimming, flying, because we had a bird, a fish, and another bird.